A graph is a set of objects in which pairs of them are related. We typically represent it as a set of vertices. In this example, we have vertices 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and a set of edges which represent the relation between the elements. So in this graph here, we have a relation between node 1 and node 2, so represented by this little edge over here. This graph here is an undirected graph, which means it has a symmetric relationship. So if you go from vertice 1 to vertice 2, it's the same as you can go from vertice 2 to vertice 1. This is similar in real life, for example, to friendship, because friendship is a symmetric relation. If you are a friend to someone else, this person is also the friend of you. Here we see the representation of this graph in a more formal sense, where we define the vertices and the edges. So edges are defined as tuples, indicating the two vertices, a start vertice and an end vertice. So this represents the graph over here. And that's a more formal way of specifying a graph, is to say graph G is equal to V, which is the set of vertices, and E, which is the set of edges. We have also directed graphs. For example, you know a famous person X is such a typical relation. That doesn't mean that this famous person knows you. And those directed graphs are represented with arrows in a more abstract mathematical formation. We define it as listed over here. And we see two examples of directed graphs. By the way, a tree is a directed graph as well, starting from the root over here. This is one of the slides which is not assessed. So it's here to give you additional information as we approach the end of the lecture. Let's get now started with more terminology. So a walk is a sequence of edges that join a sequence of vertices, such that those edges actually exist in our graph. So what does it mean? Well, in this graph here, we can start, for example, at node 1, and then we can go to node 2, because there is an edge, right? Then we can go to node 3, that's possible. Then we can go to node 1 again, then to node 2, and node 4 finally. That is a possible walk. Now there is a trail. A trail is a walk in which edges are distinct, which means you can go walk over an edge only once. Okay, so I can go from 1 to 2, to 3, to 4, to 5, to 3, to 1. Each edge I have only traversed once. So that's a valid trail. Lastly, we have a path. A path is a walk in which all the vertices are distinct. So I can go from vertice 1 to 2 to 3 to 4 to 5, but I cannot go back now from 5 to 3 because that vertice I already walked through. So this is now a maximal trail. So a maximal trail in this case means I have passed all the possible vertices. Next, we can talk a little bit about connectivity. Well, a graph may be connected. What does it mean? It means there's a path between any pair of nodes. So in this case, from any node, from node 1, I can reach node 6, and I can reach node 2, 3, 4, and 5. And so from any other node, I can reach any other node. Here's another graph in which we have two partitions which are not connected. So from this node here, I cannot reach this node because there is no connection between those two kind of sub-segments. We say a graph is cycle-free, a directed graph is cycle-free, if there is no trail where you start from a specific vertex and you move a couple of places and you return to the same vertex. So in this case, we have a cycle because we start here from this vertex, go to this vertex, go to this vertex, and come back to the same vertex. So there is clearly a cycle in this graph. If I would remove one of those edges, it would be cycle free. Here's an example where we see a cycle as well in this graph. Note that we normally say that a cycle exists only in a directed graph. because otherwise you can always return back. This here is just to for illustration purposes. So some graphs are weighted, so-called weighted graphs, which means you store numeric values either on the edges or in the nodes. So here we have the distance between the nodes in a road network. You can easily imagine that you have city 1 and city 3, and then this is the kind of the distance between those two cities. There exist also use cases in which the weight is negative. And this is really relevant for a set of algorithms that treat those cases. So, a next definition is a complete graph. It means that every vertex is connected to every other vertex. That means the number of edges for our D graph would be that each node is connected to V minus 1 nodes, which means we have O of V square many nodes. By the way, the number of edges that you can have in an undirected graph is V times V minus 1 divided by 2. So it's also in the order of V square, which means the maximum number of edges is also O of V square in any case. Right here in this case it's just half the number than we would have in a D graph. In a graph, abstract data type, typical operations are for constructing a graph or to inquire about the relations in a graph. For instance, you may want to add a vertex, you may want to remove a vertex, you may want to add an edge or remove an edge. That's about the construction of a graph. And then you may inquire it by figuring out if two nodes or two vertices are adjacent. You can ask, adjacent in the graph is U and V adjacent, so is there an edge between them? You can ask about the neighbors by retrieving from a certain node all the vertices that we have edges to. There might be various supportive operations to handle values, like you may have a value stored in a vertex, you may have a value stored on an edge, and you want to get and retrieve those values.